Welcome to Nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. In this video, we'll talk about mean circulatory feeling pressure and mean systemic feeling pressure. So let's get started. In this diagram, the initial portion is systemic circulation and the later portion is the pulmonary circulation. Now, as the heart contracts, it generates pressure and the blood flows down this pressure gradient. This graph shows the pressure along different segments of the vasculature. So this is the pressure profile when the heart is functioning. But if the heart stops pumping, the pressure generation stops. So the gradient is lost and flow stops. In such a situation, pressure in arteries, capillaries, and veins all become uniform. This pressure is called mean circulatory feeling pressure. Normally, it's about 7 millimeters of mercury. Now you might ask, if the heart has stopped pumping, where does this 7 mmHg pressure come from? Well, it's due to the feeling of the blood vessels. Just like how feeling the air inside a balloon increases the pressure inside it, feeling of vessels by blood also generates pressure. In short, the mean pressure in the circulation due to mere feeling of the blood vessels is called mean circulatory feeling pressure. It's that simple. This pressure depends on overall compliance of all blood vessels and blood volume. This graph shows the relationship between blood volume and mean circulatory feeling pressure. At a normal blood volume of about 5 liters, the mean systemic feeling pressure is about 7 millimeters of mercury. If the blood volume increases, the pressure increases, and if volume decreases, the pressure also decreases. Sympathetic stimulation constricts all blood vessels and even the heart also. This increases the pressure at each level of blood volume. Thus, the curve is shifted up. On the other hand, inhibition of sympathetic stimulation causes relaxation of blood vessels. So, the pressure for all values of blood volume decreases. So, the curve shifts down. So, this was mean circulatory feeling pressure. Now, let's talk about mean systemic feeling pressure. If we clamp the large arteries near the heart, the systemic circulation gets disconnected from the pulmonary circulation. The feeling pressure in the systemic circulation in this case is called mean systemic feeling pressure. It's almost the same as mean circulatory feeling pressure because the pulmonary circulation has less than 1/8 as much compliance as systemic circulation and only about 1/10 as much blood volume. So this was all about mean circulatory and systemic feeling pressure. We will learn more about their importance in the video on analysis of cardiac output and venous return curves. In summary, the pressure in blood vessels when the heart stops pumping is called mean circulatory or systemic feeling pressure. It depends on overall compliance of blood vessels and blood volume. That's it for this topic. For sticking with me until the end, here is a bonus point for you. In the graph, we studied the effect of sympathetic nervous system only. So you might be wondering, what about the effect of parasympathetic nervous system, right? Well, if you have seen the video on nervous regulation of blood pressure, there we saw one thing. Although the heart receives both sympathetic as well as parasympathetic innervation, most of the blood vessels in the body receive only sympathetic innervation. They do not receive parasympathetic innervation. So changes in parasympathetic activity do not produce a significant effect on blood vessels. If you want to know which vessels receive parasympathetic innervation, you can go watch that video. That's it. Please hit all the buttons that you find beneath this video. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.